Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we are going to discuss a new method called as the Modi method for optimization of transportation problem. This method includes solving the initial problem by VAM method and then getting the optimal solution by using the second method called as the Modi method. Let's start with the problem, problem number 7. Let's read the problem first. A company is spending rupees 1200 on transportation of finished goods from 3 plants to 4 distribution centers every month. The supply and the demand for finished goods every month with unit cost, that is cost per unit of transportation, are given in the following table. So we have a table here which shows us that there are 3 factories F1, F2, F3 and there are 4 distribution centers or demand centers D1, D2, D3 and D4. And every center has got certain demand. The total of my demand comes to 5, 13, 20 and 35. The total of my supply, that is the capacity of the 3 factories, also comes to 35. This means that the problem is balance. Moreover, this problem is based on unit cost of transportation. That means this problem is a minimization problem. Question is asked, there are 2 questions. First, find the optimal solution to give minimum cost schedule to transport the finished goods to market and what can be the maximum savings every month by optimal scheduling. So presently the company is spending rupees 1200 on transportation. Then we are asked to find out the optimal solution. Whenever a problem asked to find out optimal solution, we are always supposed to solve the problem by VAM plus Modi method. Second question they have asked us is what can be the maximum savings every month by optimal scheduling. Means presently they are spending rupees 1200. Now if our solution gives the answer as rupees 1000, that means by getting the optimal solution, we will get a cost of rupees 1000, which means there will be a saving of rupees 200 every month. That has been asked as the second part, but let's start the first part and then we will proceed further. Let's just draw the diagram. We have already checked the first 2 basic conditions. The problem is of minimization type. Second, the problem is balance. So now we are going to solve the problem first by VAM method and then we are going to check the optimality of the solution. Let's draw the lines first. So friends, let's write the question first. This is my question. Let's just note down the question. We have 3 factories F1, F2 and F3. We have 4 distribution centers D1, D2, D3 and D4. Here is my supply or the so called capacity and here we have the demand. So my demand is 5, 8, 7 and 15. So 5, 8, 7 and 15. So total comes to 35. And my supply is 7, 10 and 18. 7, 10 and 18. I just note down the cost now on the top left side of the cell. First column 20, 70, 30. So 20, 70, 30. Second column 30, 35, 12. 30, 35. Third column 50, 40, 60. 50, 40, 60. And last column 15, 60 and 25. 15, 60 and 25. So we have noted down the problem. Now we need to get the optimal solution. Whenever a problem asks us to find out the optimal solution, we are supposed to solve the problem first by VAM method, and then we are supposed to implement the Modi method to get the optimal solution. Let's proceed further and first obtain the initial feasible solution by VAM method. I'll note down the top of the table. Initial feasible solution by VAM. Here I will note down the row differences. Here we have the column differences. In my first row, the lowest number is 15 and the next lowest is 20. So the difference comes to 5. In the second row, the lowest number is 35 and the next lowest is 40. Again, the difference is, in the third row, my lowest number is 12 and the next lowest number is 25. The difference comes to 13. Now we'll go column wise. In the first column, lowest cost is 20, next lowest is 30. Difference shall be 10. In the second column, lowest cost is 12, next lowest is 30, difference is 18. In the third column, lowest cost is 40 and next lowest is 50, difference is 10. In the fourth column, lowest cost is 15 and the next lowest is 25, again the difference is 10. So if you observe carefully, my highest penalty or the highest column difference and the row difference comes to 18. Therefore, our first allocation will be in the second column. In the second column, my lowest cost is against 12. Therefore, supply will be 18, whereas demand will be 8. Whichever is lower will come to 8. And 8 minus 8 will be 0. 18 minus 8 will be 10. Since this column has got a 0, we are going to cancel this column. Once this column is cancelled, our column penalties will remain same. And we need to recalculate the row penalties. First row 15 and 20, the difference is 5. Second row, the lowest number is 40, next lowest is 60, difference is 20. Third row, lowest number is 25, next lowest is 30, difference is 5. After the second stage, I have got penalties of 10, 10, 5, 20 and 5, out of which the lowest is 20. And against this row, the lowest cost is 40. Against which we have a supply of 10 and a demand of 7. So whichever is less, it will come to 7. 10 minus 7, 3. 7 minus 7. Since we have a 0 here, this column will be cancelled. Again, we cancel the column. Therefore, our column penalties will remain same. Now I need to recalculate the row penalties. 20 and 15, 60 and 70, 25 and 30. So we have got penalty, highest penalty of 10 after the third row of calculation, out of which we have 10 at 3 different places. So if I take this first 10 in the row, my lowest cost is 60, supply is 3, demand is 15, whichever is less, I will put down here 3. If I take this 10, my lowest cost is 20, against which I have a supply of 7 and demand of 5. So which is lower, it will come to 5. And if I go against this particular 10, then my lowest cost is 15, against which supply is 7 and demand is 15. 7 or 15, whichever is less, comes to 7. So if I take this particular 10 as the penalty, I will make an assignment here of 3 or 15, 3. If I take this 10 as the penalty, then my lowest cost is 20. I will have 7 or 5, whichever is less may 5. And in the third case, if I take this 10 as the penalty, then my lowest cost is 15, where the supply is 7 and the demand is 15. Therefore, I will make an allocation in the cell which will allow me for the highest allocation. So 7 minus 7 is 0 and 15 minus 7 is 8. So you have got a 0 here. So this particular row shall be cancelled. Now we are left with only 2 rows. Since we have cancelled the rows, our row penalties will remain same. And my column penalties now will be 30 and 70, 60 and 25. So my highest penalty is now 40, against which we have the lowest cost at 30. Okay, how much is the demand? Demand is 5, supply is 10. So we'll supply only 5, and 5 minus 5 will become 0, and 10 minus 5 will be 5. Since this is a 0, this column shall be cancelled. Now we are left with only one column. Whenever we are left with only one column or one row, we are not supposed to make any allocations by drawing the lines. We can make the allocations directly. This 3 will be transferred here, and 3 minus 3 will become 0, and 8 minus 3 will become, and directly this 5 and 5 will be cancelled and it will be delivered here. So we have obtained, friends, the first solution by VAM method. हमने वैम मेथड से इसका इनिशियल वैल्यू निकाल लिया. अब हमें सीखना है हाउ टू गेट द ऑप्टिमल सॉल्यूशन. दिस सॉल्यूशन कैन बी कॉल्ड एज ऑप्टिमल. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ दिस इज, देयर इज नो प्रूफ दैट दिस इज द बेस्ट सॉल्यूशन. मे बी देयर कैन बी सम अनदर सॉल्यूशन व्हिच कैन बी इक्वली और मोर इफेक्टिव देन दिस. टू नो दैट सॉल्यूशन, वेदर वी कैन इंप्रूव दिस सॉल्यूशन और नॉट, we need to learn something called as the MODI method, modified distribution method. This method is called as modified distribution method. In this method, let's learn the tricks what we are going to do. Let's draw the diagram again. Now once the initial feasible solution is obtained by VAM method, now we are going to improve that solution. See, look, this solution itself is called as an initial feasible solution. So it is not the best. It is not the optimal. It won't give me the lowest possible cost. And therefore, I need to improve the solution. In order to improve any solution, we have got a test called as modified distribution test. Let's learn this modified distribution test along with the same problem. Here is my solution obtained from the VAM method for the problem number 7. Now we are going to learn something completely new called as MODI method or the modified distribution method. Let's see how it can be done. So here is our question. Let's write the question once again along with the solution. Please note, we are not going to write the row difference and the column difference. Their purpose has been done. They were introduced only at the stage of solving by VAM method. Once we obtain the solution by VAM method, there is no longer need of drawing this row differences and column differences in the next table, because they will be no longer required. If at all they will be required, we will again get them through some method. So here is my F1, F2, F3. Here is my cost 20, 70, 30, 30, 35 and 12, 50, 40 and 60, 15, 60 and 70 and 25. Supplies 7, 10 and 18, and demand was 5, 8, 7 and 15. So we got the solution. Let's note down the solution. So here we have 7. 7 as per the table, we have 3 here. We have 5 here. Then we have 7, 8, 8, then we have 5 here. First, check the optimality test. We have 3 rows. And we have 3 rows and we have 4 columns. These 4 columns, D1, D2, D3, D4, they indicate the demand. And this 3 columns, F1, F2, F3, they indicate the supply. Here I will note down U and here I will note down V. This U and V are the parameters that have been introduced by us just to check the optimality of the solution. Okay, just like we are checked for the various ailments or the disease by the doctors, in the same manner the problem has got certain steps which we are required to verify before actually starting with the Modi method. What we are supposed to do? If you look at the table, there are certain columns with circles around them. So we have 15, 60, 20, 40, 12, 30. This can be called as the occupied cells because this particular cells contain a circle, means there is an allocation in that cell, which means that that will be called as a occupied cell. So I have got occupied cell here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So my number of occupied cells is how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number of rows plus columns minus 1. Number of rows plus columns minus 1. How many rows we have? We have 3 factories. We have 4 different warehouses. Minus 1 comes to how much? Whereas your number of occupied cells are how much? That means I can proceed further. So before proceeding further, remember one thing. You always need to check whether the number of rows and columns that are occupied, jin jin boxes ke andar circles hai, un sab ko aapko occupied cells consider karna. Aur ye jo occupied cells honge, inhe मैच करना है विद द नंबर ऑफ रोज 3 प्लस नंबर ऑफ कॉलम्स 4 माइनस 1. सो आई गॉट 6, माई नंबर ऑफ ऑक्युपाइड सेल्स आर ऑल्सो 6. दैट मीन्स दिस टेबल कैन बी इम्प्रूव्ड बाय यूजिंग द मेथड कॉल्ड एज मोदी मेथड. सो वी हैव द नंबर ऑफ ऑक्युपाइड सेल्स इक्वल टू द नंबर ऑफ रोज प्लस कॉलम्स माइनस 1. माई नंबर ऑफ रोज वेर 3. My number of columns were 4, 3 plus 4 minus 1 is 6. My number of occupied cells are 6. That means this problem should give me the optimal solution. So now let's check how I can improve the solution by using the Modi method. We have to introduce two parameters, U and V. U and V indicate, yeah, they are introduced just to find out whether this table can get us the optimal solution. We will introduce a 0 in the first row against U, and now we are supposed to calculate the values of U and V. Before proceeding further, how to calculate U and V? We have got a formula for every occupied cell. For every occupied cell, U will be equal to cost minus V. For every occupied cell, 15, 60, 40, 25, 12, 30, all these are my occupied cells. For every occupied cell, U will be equal to cost minus V, and V will be equal to cost minus. These two formulas are required to be used while calculating the values of U and V. We are going to use only the occupied cells. And my formula will be, to calculate the V, I will use the formula cost minus U. And to calculate the U, I will use the formula cost minus V. Let's see, we'll go extremely slow at this part. This is the most typical part of the problem. How to calculate U and V? We need to work out the workings here. So we have occupied cells. Let's first try it out orally. We have occupied cells. We have introduced a 0 here. Now in the first row, which is the occupied cell? 15. How much is the cost? 15. Cost minus U. C minus U will get me V. So 15 minus 0 will be 15. So I am using only the occupied cells to calculate the values of U and V. So we introduce a 0 here. Conventionally, we always introduce the 0 in the first row. Then in the first row, we had this occupied cell. So I said 15 minus 0 will be 15. Now I got this 15. Which are the occupied cells in this particular column? We have 2. 60 minus 15 will give me 45. And then we have 25 minus 15. So we had a 0 here. Using the 0, I calculated this 15. Occupied cell is 7. 15 minus 0. Remember, you have to subtract the cost minus U, not the allocation minus U. And therefore, 15 minus 0 will be 15. And in this particular column, it will be 60 minus 15, 45. 25 minus 15, 10. Now, I had obtained this 0 first, then I obtained the 15. By using the 15, I have obtained these two numbers. Now comes the remaining part. We need to ensure that we get all the values of U and V before we proceed further in the Modi method. I can say calculation of U and V is nothing but the basic preparation to start the Modi method. So we have already done with the U and U's. Now we are supposed to do with the V's. I will take this third column. occupied cell is 7. How much is the cost? 40. Cost minus U will give me V. So 40 minus 45 will be minus 5. Then we have one more occupied cell here. Let's check out 60 minus 45, 15. 25 minus 15, 10. In this row, we have occupied cell 12. So 12 minus 10. And we have 30 minus 10, 20. So by finding the U and the V values, we are going to check the optimality of the solution. Let's now proceed further to find out whether this table can give me the best solution or not, or whether the solution that we have obtained so far, the initial feasible solution, it is optimal or not. So we obtain the table. Now we have to check for unoccupied cells. U and V were calculated by using the occupied cells. Now we need to make the calculation for unoccupied cells. We have got a very simple formula for unoccupied cells. For unoccupied cells, we calculate a value called as delta. Now delta can be calculated by putting the formula cost minus U plus V. Cost minus U plus V will get you the value of the unoccupied cell, which will be called as the delta. In my first row, I have F1 D1 which is unoccupied. I have F1 D2 which is unoccupied. I have F1 D3 as unoccupied. I will just note down F1 D1, F1 D2 and F1 D3. For F1 D1, what is the cost? 20. For F1 D1, the cost is 20 minus what is the corresponding U and the V? U is 0 and cost V is 20. So cost minus U plus V. 20 minus U plus V. That is 20 minus 0 plus 20. So 20 minus, for the second row, for the second column, first row, we have cost 30 minus U plus V. So 30 minus 0 plus 2. 30 minus 0 plus 2. Then we have F1 D3 where the cost is 50 minus 0 plus minus 5. 50 minus 0 plus minus 5. Then we have F2 D1 which is unoccupied, cost is 70. Then note down F2 D1, cost is 70 minus 10 plus 5. 70 minus 45 plus 20. Then we have F2 D2. F2 D2 cost is 35. 35 minus 45 plus 2. 35 minus 45 plus 2. Then we have F3 D3 cost is 60 minus 10 plus minus 5. F3 D3 cost is 60 minus 10 plus minus 5. So we are done with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 unoccupied cells. We have got the values for 6 unoccupied cells. Let's calculate these values. So my first value will be 0. My second value will be 28. My third value will be 50 minus minus 5 will be 50 plus 5, that is 55. My fourth value will be 70 minus 45 plus 20 is 65, this comes to 5. My fifth value will be 35 minus 45 plus 2 minus 12, and last value will be 60 minus 10 plus minus 5, that is 55. So we obtain the values called as the delta values for unoccupied cells. Let's put down those values in the table. Now where should I write the delta values? Ideally delta values are always written on the within the bracket. We write out the delta values. What are my delta values? F1, D1, 0. F1, D2, 28. F1, D3, 55. F1, D3, 55. F2 W1 5, F2 5, F2 D2 minus 12, F2 D2 minus 12, and last is F3 D3 is 55. So friends, we have obtained a solution by using the Modi method. Modi method is very easy to understand. The first step we are going to do is we are going to put down U and V. We introduce the U and V here. After introducing U and V, we have calculated the U and V values by using the formula. By using the formula, cost is equal to cost minus V equals to U, or V equals to cost minus U. Using this either of the two formulas, we have obtained the allocations. Now the question that has been raised is that whether this is the optimal solution or not. And so we went for the second method called as the Modi method. Modified distribution method. What this method tells us? This method is started with calculation of U and V, and then we calculated the values of unoccupied cells and noted down in this table. If you observe, there is one negative value. This minus 12 in this particular cell indicates that this solution is not the best solution. Agar aapke question mein delta values negative aata hai, iska matlab aapka solution optimal solution nahi hai. अब ऑप्टिमल सॉल्यूशन निकालने के लिए आप इस टेबल में क्या करोगे? यू नीड टू लुक एट द अनऑक्युपाइड सेल विद द नेगेटिव वैल्यू. हमारा एक अनऑक्युपाइड सेल है जिसका वैल्यू नेगेटिव है. हम इसी को लेके प्रॉब्लम को सॉल्व करेंगे. हाउ टू वर्क इट आउट? यू नीड टू ड्रॉ समथिंग कॉल्ड एज lines, and these lines are drawn in a form of a loop. Now what is a loop exactly? A loop is a diagram that is drawn with a continuous drawing without lifting your hand. Agar aap bina haath uthaye koi bhi diagram bana lete ho to us diagram ko kaha jayega loop. There must not be any kind of overriding. There must not be any kind of diagonal lines while drawing the loop. Let's now draw the loop in this diagram. How that loop will appear? Let's see to it. We'll start the loop at the point where we have the highest negative value. So we had a value minus 12 here. I'm going to use this point, or this is my point of origin from where my loop will start. Now in this loop, you will have to make a loop, and you can change the directions only at occupied cells. Aap sirf aur sirf occupied cells pe hi loop ka direction change kar sakte ho. So I am trying to make a loop from here by using this negative value. और इसको लेके अगर मैं लूप बनाता हूँ 8, 5, 3 एंड बैक, सो इट विल बिकम मच इजियर टू सॉल्व. और अदर वे आई कैन गो, इज देयर एनी अदर वे? लेट्स सी. इफ आई गो एट 7, नाउ एट 7 इट्स अ ऑक्यूपाइड सेल, सो आई कैन चेंज द डायरेक्शन, बट आई वोंट गो अप, आई वोंट गो डाउन बिकॉज देयर इज नो एंड सर्कल और ऑक्यूपाइड सेल टू चेंज द डायरेक्शन. And therefore, I am left with no choice but to simply add this and make a loop by using 3, went to 3, then we have to go to 2, from 2 I will go to 8 and I will again back to the same point. This shall be called as a loop. In this loop, we started from this cell 35, we jumped on 60. We came to 25 and we came back to 12 and back to the same point. In every loop, there will be only one occupied cell, unoccupied cell, and all the other cells will be occupied. मेरे इस loop में ये particular cell मेरा unoccupied है. Then I went to 3, occupied, 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 and back to the same point. अब next step में हम draw करेंगे इसमें lines. Now lines are required to be drawn with this arrow in my next step. I'll just put the signs. I'll start with the unoccupied cell and put a big plus here. From here we went to 3, I'll put a minus here. Then we went to 5, I will again put a plus here. And then we went to 8, I'll again put a minus. So now I started the loop, I made a loop, and now we have drawn the sign of plus and minus. We started from this point, I put a plus here for the unoccupied cell. Then next place, negative sign. Again I jump to the next place, positive sign. Again I jump to the next place, negative sign. So we have two positives, we have two negatives. Now we have to look at the allocation. That is the amounts hidden inside the circle. अभी आपको circle के अंदर का values देखना है, ना कि उस cell के cost को देखना है. So मेरे पास इस particular loop में यहाँ पर minus में 3 है और यहाँ पर minus में 8 है. I have got 3 and 8 at the negative terminals. I'll select the lowest among the two. So 3 or 8, whichever is lower, me will get 3. So I will subtract the 3 from here. I'll subtract the 3 from here. So 8 minus 3 will be 5. And 3 minus 3, this will become 0. That is unoccupied cell. Whatever has been subtracted from these two particular corners will be added at these two particular corners. So here it was unoccupied. Now it will become occupied. And here it was earlier 5, now 5 plus 3, it shall become. So we made a loop, then we gave a signature plus minus, out of the negative values we selected one with the lowest allocation of 3. So I subtracted 3 from here, I subtracted 8 minus 3, 5. जितना आपने यहाँ से minus किया उतना ही आपको problem को balance करने के लिए फिर से यहाँ पे add करना होगा. तो we added 3 here, which was unoccupied, and 5 plus 3, 8 here. So by this method, I improved the solution. हमने इस method से, इस Modi method से हमने इस solution को improve किया. Now I need to draw this diagram again to find out whether this new solution obtained is optimal or not. How to work it out? Let's draw the table again. We have this workings which will form the part of the answer. Now we'll start with the next table. I'll draw the lines. Possibly and preferably, always use a pencil for making the loop. That way it will become much easier for you to practice and to understand the things. Or else it will become too messy and there will be too much of overwriting while solving the problem. Let's draw the diagram again. So we are just going to draw the diagram, the table again. This table will contain the same values. We are going to copy the whole table again with the new values written with the red pen. So F1, F2, F3 are my three factories. F1, F2, F3 and D1, D2, D3, D4 are my four distribution centers. D1, D2, D3 and D4. And then we have the demand and the supply. So here I have the supply, here I have the demand. So just note down the solution. Now remember, while copying the same table after applying the Modi method once, never copy the delta values and the U and the V values. As I discussed earlier, this value should never be copied. They will be calculated at every stage whenever we are going to solve by Modi method. There is no need to copy these values in the next table. I'll just draw the original table that was there in the question. So 20, 70, 30. So 20, 70, 30. Then we add 30, 35 and 12. 30. 35 and 12. We have 50, 40, 60. And then we have 15, 60 and 25. 15, 60 and 25. And we have the supply 7, 10 and 18. And we have 5, 8, 7 and 15. So we have simply copied the whole table again without drawing U and V values and without putting down the values of the delta from the unoccupied cells. We'll now put the allocations here. We already had 7 here. We have a 8 here now. We have a 5 here and 5 here. Then we have a 3 here in F2, D2. And we have a 7 here at 40. So our number of occupied cells are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. At every stage, we are going to again check the number of occupied cells, because for Modi method it is very important that the number of occupied cells must be exactly equal to the number of rows and the number of columns minus 1. So aapka number of occupied cells kitna hai? 6. And number of rows plus columns minus 1. I got 3 rows, that is 3 factories, plus 4 demand centers minus 1 should be 6. And even our number of occupied cells are 6. That means this table will not degenerate. Let's now try to find out the values of U and V for this second table by Modi method. What we are doing here is exactly we are trying to test the optimality of the solution, whether the solution that has been obtained by us is optimal or not. I just put down a 0 here first. Now since I put down a 0 here, my first row mein sabse jyada allocation yahi pe hua hai, 7. So 15 minus 0. 15 minus 0 will be 15. तो ये जीरो से हमको ये 15 मिला। अब ये वाले कॉलम में और ऑक्यूपाइड है क्या? 25। सो 25 माइनस 15 10। नेक्स्ट इज इन दिस कॉलम वी हैव 12 एंड 30 एज द ऑक्यूपाइड सेल्स। सो 12 माइनस 10 2 and even this is occupied 30 minus 10, so we haven't got a value here. How can I get this value and how can I get this value at F2? In this cell we have got an occupied cell here, 35 minus 2 is 33, and then 40 minus 33 will be 7. So we have obtained the U and the V values of the occupied cells. Remember, you need to find out the value of occupied of U and V by using only the occupied cells. So we had a 0 here, 15 minus 0 is 15, 25 minus 15 is 10, 12 minus 10 is 2, 30 minus 10 is 20, then I had an occupied cell here, 35 minus 2 20, 33. I had occupied cell here, 40 minus 7 is 33, okay, and so on. So what we have done is exactly we have obtained a solution, or I should say we have improved the solution a lot. But then whether this is the best solution or not, for that we need to check the optimality of the solution. Okay, how to check the optimality of the solution of the existing table? Again, we need to draw a new table by finding the delta values of U and V. Let's find out the values of U and V for unoccupied cell. For unoccupied cell, my first unoccupied cell is F1 D1. My second unoccupied cell is F1 D2, third is F1 D3. So we are finding out the delta values of unoccupied cell. Unoccupied cell delta values. First one is F1 D1 20 minus U plus V, that is 20 minus 0 plus 20. So 20 minus 0 plus 20 at F1 D2. My cost is 30, my corresponding U is 0 and corresponding V is 2. So 30 minus 0 plus 2. 30 minus 0 plus 2, that comes to at F1 D3 my cost is 50 minus 0 plus 7. Next unoccupied cell we have is F2 D1, cost is 70 minus 33 plus 20. 70 is the cost, cost minus U plus V. So cost is 70 minus 33 plus 20. F2 D1 cost is 70 minus 33 plus 20, that is 17. My next cell, unoccupied cell is F2 D4. My cost is 60 minus U plus V. So 60 minus 33 plus 15, F2 D4, 60 minus 33 plus 15. Next unoccupied cell I have is one more 60 at F3 D3, 60 minus 10 plus 7. 60 minus 10 plus 7. Now we need to calculate the delta values of unoccupied cells. We have calculated already for first 4, 0, 28, 43 and 17. Here it comes to 60 minus 33 plus 15 is 48. So 60 minus 48 will be 12 and 60 minus 17 will be 43. So we have got all the positive values of unoccupied cells. That's a very positive sign for us. You just note down the values 0, 28, 43. So we have a 0, 28, 43, then we have 17, 12 and 43, 17, 12 and 43. So we obtain all the delta values of unoccupied cells, which is 0, 28, 43, 17. And then we have got 43 and 12. So none of the values are negative. We will note down since delta values of unoccupied cells are positive, solution is optimal. That means the solution we have obtained by improving the original solution has been improved by us by using the Modi method, and we tested this method again for new U and V values and the delta values, and the delta values of all the unoccupied cells are non-negative. They are non-negative, means they are either zero or they are positive. Therefore, I will say that the solution will be optimal. What shall be my final solution now? The final solution will be transportation cost equals to I'll just note down this in the next page. My transportation cost shall be now, we will find the final answer by multiplying these quantities that we are going to supply with the unit cost. So it will be 7 into 15, 7 into 40, 3 into 35, 8 into 25, 5 into 12, 5 into 30. That will give me the best solution. So let's try to get the final solution. So my total transportation cost shall be equal to, first I will multiply 7 units multiplied by 15. This shall be 7 into 15 plus, it will be 3 into 35 plus, it will be 7 into 40. Next, it shall be 5 into 30 and 5 into 12. And then we have 8 into 25. 8 into 25. This comes to 105 plus 105 plus 280 plus 150 plus 60 plus 200. This will be 105, 210, 290, 390, 490, 590. 590 plus 50 will be 640, 700. And my total cost will be 900. So, you can see from the given solution, I have simply multiplied 7 into 15, 3 into 35, 7 into 40, 5 into 30, 5 into 12 and 8 into 25. And this is what has been obtained by me. So my total cost or the optimum cost of transportation will be 900 rupees. They had asked one more question in the problem to us, is that whether is there any savings by using this method. So I will say my earlier transportation cost, my present cost of transportation is 1200 rupees, and my optimum cost of transportation is 900 rupees, so there will be a saving of rupees 300. So this was the solution. There are two parts. The first part, they are asked us to calculate the final answer. We calculated the answer. And the second part, they had asked us to indicate how much is the savings. The savings will be 300 rupees. Thanks for watching this video. Do subscribe to our channel, eKida.